रजनी, असिस्टेंट प्रोफेसर डिपार्टमेंट ऑफ मटेरियल अमेरिका ज्योति विद्यापीठ वुमेन्स यूनिवर्सिटी. इन प्रीवियस लेक्चर्स वी हैव डिस्कस्ड रिगार्डिंग द एंटीमोनियम क्रूडम्स प्रिपरेशन एंड द स्फीयर ऑफ एक्शंस. नाउ टुडे वी विल बी डिस्कसिंग अबाउट द मेंटल सिम्टम्स ऑफ एंटीमोनियम क्रूडम. So the first thing, when I was talking about the preparation and also the sphere of action, we have seen the production or the disease conditions, how it gets evolved and how it gets produced. So in engineering freedom, the first thing what we see, the diseases, how it gets produced or from where it gets originated, is disappointments. So the first thing from where it comes is disappointments. Especially from any of the love affairs or any of the close associated or attached persons. So any kind of hurt, betrayal, deceit which comes from the person whom they have been in love with, from there it originates. Now how it leads? So the first thing what we see is the element that is being seen as disappointment, which is coming from the loved ones. Now it originates from here. Now how it evolves is the second thing what we see as a part of it is desire for solitude. They do not prefer company. Rather, the third thing what we see in these patients is getting sentimental. Antimonial crudum patients are highly sentimental, especially by the moonlight. So, if you put any of the normal person in moonlight, they do not have any kind of emotions, affections being arose. But if a person having the antimonial crudum origins, they get very much sentimental after looking at the moon. Also, they used to remember all the heartbreaks, all of the hurtful feelings that have happened to them while sitting under the moonlight. So this is very much important for antimonial crudum patients. Again, after this, we see the suicidal dispositions. At the later stages, we see after all these symptoms have evolved, they also get the dispositions of suicide. That too, especially by shooting themselves. And second thing, how they get is by drowning. So either they think of going into the water and drown themselves, or the second part what they think of is by shooting themselves up, right? So these are the two things how they want to end up their lives. Next, what we see is they do not prefer to be looked at or to be touched by anyone. Especially in the children, you see that they're irritable by looking at them or by touching them. So if at all in the kids it is very much evident and clear. If at all you look at the kid, they either smile, you know, or they used to talk to you, they used to come up to you, you know, or they play. But if they are antimonial crudum child especially, if you are looking at them for 2 to 3 minutes, they get angry. Right? So they are very much cross and irritable, they get angry. Also, if you go around them and you try to touch them, right, they just run away. They get irritated and they run away. They start weeping also at times. So these are the few symptoms which you see and which guides us to antimonial crudum. This is similar actually, this depressive stage is similar to retromune, which was a study in compilation, right? So retromune patients also, we have got these kind of elements. But here the most important thing is disappointment from the loved ones. There what we see is one of the factor as disappointed from the loved ones. Also any kind of grief, that is from the loss of loved ones. That is after the death of loved ones, after the sickness of loved ones. So any kind of grief is going to be under the natural view. But if it is specifically after the loss, deceit or mistrust or the betrayal by the loved one, it comes under envy too. Right? So this is the basic difference. Although the symptoms or the presentations used to be similar, one more dissimilarity is the sentimental mood. What you see in the antimonium crudum is not present in netramuriaticum patients. So this is not seen in netramur patients. Alright? So these are the few guiding symptoms, mental guiding symptoms for antimonium crudum. Next, we'll be listening to or studying this further in the next class. Thank you very much.